I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome everybody to our Junior High Awards presentation. We will start off by recognizing our eighth graders, followed by Junior High Awards, and lastly, our slideshow. We'd like to thank Mrs. Guyman for preparing the slideshow.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
I think you know who I am. I am fortunate to be able to give away four awards today for $250 each to four deserving students who have excelled in one or more of our big three. The big three at Southeastern is attendance, discipline, and academics. And as I said, our students did extremely well this year, and four of them are going to be rewarded with $250. This is an exciting part for me of the whole awards day, and let's go ahead and get started. First of all, you can see on the screen I have all of the students who have excelled this year in attendance, And by excelling this year, we mean any student who achieved an attendance rate of 94% or greater. That 94% is consistent with our incentives. And each of these students, I believe there are 46 of them, met the requirements of 94% or greater. So at this point, we basically want to narrow it down and try to find one winner. I like to have a little fun with these. Right now, I'm going to try. You'll notice I have some students with font of red and some students with black font. And what I want to do right now is call my friend Mr. Rigg and see if he can help us narrow down and find ourselves a winner. So let's go ahead and call Mr. Rigg, see what he's doing. Hopefully he's available. He can help us out.
Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Rigg, this is Mr. Kerr. How's it going?
Good.
How are you?
Good, thank you. Hey, I'm doing the Big Three Awards for the Junior High Assembler, the Junior High Awards Day. Can you help me out? I got a couple questions I want to ask.
Absolutely.
Okay, thanks. Are you close? It's kind of like a ringing, like I can almost hear you echo. And can you just say something again?
Yeah, I'd love to be there to help you out if I can.
Okay. Actually, Mr. Rigg's right there. So we're going to go ahead and hang up now. We'll continue our conversation. Yeah, sorry about that. So Mr. Rigg, question is, do you play much cards?
I play a lot of cards.
A lot of cards, okay. Pretty good at it, I assume?
Decent,
okay, above average. What's your favorite suit?
I like Ace.
Okay, now that would be okay, individual card. How about suit? What would be your favorite suit?
Ace of Diamonds.
Like the, he likes the Ace. Ace of Diamonds. Okay, since you're an Ace of Diamonds guy, the diamonds are red, so we're going to actually delete out all of the students' names that are in black. So take me just a second, if I can remember to do this right. We're going to get rid of all of the clubs people and all the spades people here and keep the students whose names are in red. Mr. Rigg, while I'm doing this, if you wouldn't mind, could you just think about one of your favorite pets that you remember having as a child? And I'm going to ask you a question about that pet here in a second. So just be thinking about a pet that you had as a child that you really first fell in love with.
All right, we'll do.
All right, we got one more here. If I do this right. Yeah, I didn't do it right again. Hang with me. Really bad at this, sorry. You have nothing better to do though. Once again, for those of you who are just tuning in, we're giving away $250 to a student who has excelled this year in attendance. We are currently, for the second time, highlighting the students' names that are in black. And if this goes well, they'll be gone. If this doesn't go well, we're going to be reshooting this. Delete selected rows. We only have one here left. Sorry, Amanda and Margaret Stevens. All right, students in red are left. So these students are still eligible for the $250. Mr. Rigg, what was this pet I was referring to earlier?
It was a cat.
A cat. Was this cat a male cat or a female cat?
Female.
Female cat. So we are going to eliminate the male students that are in this list. So we're gonna eliminate Aiden. And Logan, Mrs. Harrison, help me out if I miss anybody. Blake, we're going to get rid of Julius. Mason is no longer involved. Carter's gone. Jesse's gone. James is gone. Brody. Rampley's gone. Sorry, Owen Riggs not eligible for $250. Jarrett Van Beck. So those students are gone, which leaves us with the ladies.
Owen's still on there.
Who is? Mr. Rigg, how'd you do that? You working your sorcery there? Owen Rigg, still gone. Okay, so now we're down to Gracie, Caitlin, Hannah, Zoe, Kylie, Kendra, Cassie, Katie, Cassie, Abigail, Mia, and Lily. Students still eligible for the $250. We're going to go with a random number now. So what I want to do right now is go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We happen to have, this is going to be fantastic. We have to actually have 12 students still in the running. And clean it up a little bit for you. There's those students' numbers. What I'm going to do now is take you to a random generator of numbers, and let's do the old dice shaker, one of my all-time favorites. What we're looking for now is we're looking for the number for the student who's going to win our $250. I'm going to go with two dice, and I'm going to show you first how this works. We'll get the dice shaken, and we'll roll it. So the number 7, if this would have been real, the number 7 would have been the winner. Now we're going to actually go through. The number that's shown on the next roll will be the winner of $250. And there's our shake. Shake, 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 shake. And the winner will be number 6. And going back to number 6, drum roll please. Number 6, the winner is Kendra Jade Lily. Congratulations to Kendra. Attendance, great job. You're the winner of $250. Congratulations to Kendra.
Hi, I'm Keela Wewell. I teach 7th and 8th grade math and 8th grade social studies. Today I will be giving awards to the students in my classes that achieve the highest averages. Before I get started, I want to thank Mrs. Perry. Mrs. Perry is the paraprofessional in my room, and she's the glue that keeps my classes together. Without Mrs. Perry, my room would not run as smoothly as it does. Thank you, Mrs. Perry, for all you do for me and my students. Now for math awards. First hour, 8th grade math, highest average goes to Jesse Johnson. Congratulations, Jesse. Second hour, 8th grade math, highest average, Owen Rick. Congratulations, Owen. Fourth hour, 7th grade math, highest average, Savannah Ramsey. Congratulations, Savannah. Sixth hour, 7th grade math, highest average, Haley Fecht. Congratulations, Haley. Social studies, third hour, social studies, highest average, Hannah Insminger. Congratulations, Hannah. Fifth hour, social studies, highest average, Owen Rigg. Congratulations, Owen. Before I go, I just want to say thank you to the students for an amazing year. 7th graders, for the 3 quarters that I have taught you, you've been a lot of fun, and I look forward to making more memories with you next year. 8th graders, for the past 2 years, you've been an amazing class. I look forward to seeing all that you achieve in high school. Good luck in your future.
It's time for another big three. We're looking at academics this time. We're going to give $250 away for the student who excelled in academics. For this game, we are saying that students who were on the high honor roll for the first semester are eligible for this $250 award. As you can see, I have once again a list of students on the screen. The students in yellow are our 7th graders, and the students in this blue color are our 8th graders. Let's go ahead and get to it. We want to start eliminating students and determine who our $250 winner is. To narrow it down, I'm going to rely on one of my favorite all-time games on here, and that is the machine number picker. I like to call it the cog machine. What we're going to do here is we're going to say our choices are keep 7th grade, get rid of 7th grade. We're going to say keep 8th grade. We're going to say get rid of eighth grade. So those are our four choices. We're gonna set this machine going. Once again, I'll show you what this does, and then the second time through will be our actual determination. So push a button. So in this case, we would have kept the seventh graders. Let's go ahead and reset the machine. No, 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 no. And 3, 2, 1, we'll push the button. And this time we're gonna, once again, keep seventh grade. Just to show you that this is not a sham. Keep seventh grade. All right, so we're gonna keep seventh grade. So go back to here, and we're gonna keep our seventh graders, which means that our eighth graders are no longer eligible for this particular award. We delete those rows. And that leaves us just with our seventh graders. To narrow down a little further, I like to go fishing every once in a while, so let's go fishing. I have happened to have a random fishing app that we cannot use. There we can, maybe. There we go. So we're looking at, let's go with, reset this thing real fast, and let's say we want to keep the boys, keep the girls, get rid of boys, or get rid of girls. Those are our four choices. I'll go ahead and set it. Once again, I'll catch one fish to show you what it looks like. Get rid of boys, for example. So in this case, we'll reset it, and this time we'll go fishing, and this is actually will be what we'll do. In this case, we're going to keep the girls. So, gentlemen, you are no longer with us. Logan Bolin, Jaron Henry, Carson Kerr, sorry buddy, Owen Northern, Griffey, Jaden, and Mitchell. We're gonna get rid of those guys. I did it again. Terrible, terrible, terrible. All right, all ladies now. Gracie, Savannah, Amanda. Nope, no Jaden. Sorry, Jaden. All right, Gracie, Savannah, Amanda, and Lily. So sometimes I just like wish I could just draw some name out of the hat. So let's see if we can find a way to just draw a name out of the hat. Gracie, Savannah, Amanda, and Lily. Let's see. Oh, look at that. We have a hat. And we just happen to have some names. So we can go Gracie, Savannah, Amanda, and Lily. Wow, that's good spelling. Good typing. All right, those are our four names. And we're gonna set it. Let's go with survivor style. And we wanna not have your name called. So if you have your name called, you're out. You're no longer, you're not the winner, you're out of the drawing. Amanda, you do not get to win. So sorry. Now we're down to three. Lily, you are also not a winner. Thanks for playing. So that leaves us with Gracie and Savannah. Let's go true survivor. Now you want your name. We're down to two lit. We're down to two names. Now you want your name drawn. So the name that's drawn next will be the winner of $250. And three, and two, and one, a little magic, little hocus pocus. And the winner of 250 is Savannah Ramsey. Congratulations to Savannah. That was for academics, high honor roll. Congratulations, $250.
Hi, this is Mrs. Twidwell, and I will be presenting the Junior High Language Art Awards for the overall highest grade for this school year. The first award is for my third hour eighth grade class, and this goes to Brylin Lance with 102%. The second award is for my fourth hour seventh grade class, and this award goes to Andon Acres with 90%. The next award is for my fifth hour, eighth grade class, and this goes to Hannah Insminger with 92%. The last award is for my sixth hour, seventh grade class, and there was a tie. So this award goes to both Gracie Arthur and Savannah Ramsey with 102%. Thank you.
Discovery members are first-year junior high FFA members. The Discovery degree is the first of five possible degrees for members to earn. It is awarded to eighth grade students who completed the offered agricultural course. They must have participated in at least one chapter activity outside of class time, and they must have paid their dues and shown an interest in the FFA organization. It is my honor to recognize this year's 2020 Discovery degree recipients: Wyatt Bartimus, Caden Dighton, Mason Fry, Ariel Graham, Zoe Griswold, Carter Hitz, Jesse Johnson, Chloe Kinehart, Brylan Lance, Kendra Lilly, Owen Rigg, Abigail Schaefer, Jarrett Van Beck, and Gunnar Whitaker. Congratulations. This year, the officer team would like to recognize our most active Discovery FFA member with the chapter Star Discovery Award. Congratulations to Carter Hitz, and best of luck in your future FFA experiences. To all my first and second semester Discovery Agriculture students, thank you for taking my class. I hope that you not only had some fun, but you also gained a new interest in the FFA organization and you learned about the agricultural industry. You guys were a great class to have. I wish you the best of luck in all your future endeavors.
And we are giving out another $250, this time for students who excelled in discipline. In order to excel in discipline this year, our students would have to have received zero discipline strikes. So we have a list of students. Some of them are in green and some of them are in red. Once again, that looks like our seventh graders are in green and our eighth graders are in red. We also have a number beside each student. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You'll notice 1 through 6. So let's go ahead and go back with our dice. Hang on a second. Phone call. Hello?
Hey, it's Mr. Rigg.
Mr. Rigg, this is embarrassing. Sorry. Doing another 250 actually right now. So kind of, what you need real fast?
Well, I like cats. I think we need to pick the cats category.
You mean something with cats? I had the fish, but we need cats.
I like.
Okay. Did you have a name for your cat?
I think it was Cuddles.
I'm sure it was Cuddles. Okay. Well, I'll see what I can find, and if not, sorry, but thanks for the phone call. Appreciate it. All right, bye-bye.
Bye.
Sorry about that. That was our fault. I should have put my phone on mute this time so I don't get interrupted. Okay, so we're down to, discipline. We have 7th graders are in green, 8th graders are in red, numbers 1 through 6. Let's go back to I love the pop-up dice game. Let's do the pop-up dice game. Let me show you how it works, just because I think it's fun. Pop it up, look at that one. Let's do two numbers, and we'll keep two numbers, and we'll throw away four numbers. So the first number we're gonna keep will be number 2, and the second number we're gonna keep will be number 5. So we're gonna keep 2s and 5s. So 1s are gone, 3s and 4s and 6s are gone, 1s are gone, 3, 4, 6 are gone, 1's gone, 3, 4, 6 is gone, 1's gone, 3, 4, 6 is gone, and 1, 3, 4, 6, and one more time, 1, 3, 4, 6. If I mess this up, I'm gonna be ticked. Delete. I got a 6 to get rid of, right? Mm-hmm. Get rid of that one. Okay, so now we're down to a few less. Let's get rid of either the 7th grade or the 8th grade. So let's go back to a random number. Let's do a dice spinner. And let's go with the numbers. Let's do this. We've got some seventh graders, some eighth graders, 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 and set up our wheel. So we will spin for the students that we're going to keep. So if your number gets pulled up, then we're going to keep you. So we'll spin. We're going to keep the... We're going to keep the 8th graders. So we're going to get rid of the 7th graders. Sorry, Cars. We're going to get rid of these cats. There you go, Mr. Rigg. We're going to get rid of these cats. That's what you wanted, right?
Correct.
Okay. So we have Aaliyah French, Carter Hitz, James Landon, and Katie O'Neill, and Angelina Stiegel are the ones that are left. So we have 5. Let's go ahead and... get rid of, well, let's just go a little further. Let's go ahead and go with our dice again. They were pretty good to the 5s and 2s before. Let's go ahead and eliminate either the 5s or the 2s based on whichever number comes up next. It might take us a second. We're going to eliminate the 5s or the 2s depending on which number comes up next. We're going to eliminate the 2s. We're going to eliminate the 2s. So 2s are gone. So we have... that person's gone, and this person's gone. So that leaves us with 3 students, Aaliyah, James, and Angelina. Let's go to, let's see what would be fun. Let's go to the claw number picker. One of my all-time favorites, Aaliyah, James, and Angelina. And since I can't spell Aaliyah or Angelina, we're going to go French, Landon, and Stiegel. French, Landon, and Stiegel. Where are we at? There we go. Let's set up names. French, Landon, and Angelina. Is that close? 3. French, Landon, and Angelina. All right, we have the claw set. Let me once again show you how it works. Landon, James, you would have been the winner. Congratulations, but you're not the winner. So if you get picked again, then you're the winner. If not, then you're not the winner. Ready, we're gonna reset it. This is gonna be your winner of 250. Winner of 250, here we go. James Landon, congratulations, you are the winner. Just to show you that it is a random. James, you were like, James, you were destined to win this 250, buddy. There we go. All right, so James Landon, congratulations, where are you at? You are the winner of our $250 for discipline. Way to not get in trouble this year, buddy.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Skyman, and I'm going to present our Science and Health Awards. Before I begin, I'd like to thank Mrs. Perry for all her hard work and dedication to our students. We are all blessed to have her in the classroom. For first hour, 7th grade science, the following students received a 100% or higher: Gracie Arthur, Jaron Henry, Carson Kerr, Savannah Ramsey, Amanda Stevens, Jaden Turpin, and Liliana Weiss. The top grade goes to Savannah Ramsey. In second hour, 7th grade science, the top grade goes to Caitlin Daniels. For third hour, 7th grade health, the top grade goes to Mitchell Wilcox. In fourth hour, 8th grade science, the following students received a 100% or higher: Brylan Lance, Owen Rigg, Abigail Schaefer, Jarrett Van Beck, and Mason Fry. The top grade goes to Owen Rigg. In fifth hour, 7th grade health, the following students had a 100% or higher: Gracie Arthur, Jaron Henry, Carson Kerr, Savannah Ramsey, Griffin Tippy, Jaden Turpin, and Liliana Weiss. The top grade goes to Savannah Ramsey. In sixth hour, 8th grade science, the following students had a 100% or higher: Zoe Griswold and Caitlin O'Neill. The top grade goes to Caitlin O'Neill. I'd like to recognize a student for outstanding achievement in completing the Environmental Awareness Project during remote learning. Congratulations to Kendra Lilly on your creativity and artwork. I'd also like to thank all the junior high students on a great year. I'm proud of all of you for your hard work and achievement in the science classroom. At this time, I'm going to present the Junior High Science Club Awards. Aiden Akers and Andon Akers tested the effect of nanoparticles on Daphnia magna. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating and third overall in zoology. At the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating in the Mosley Consumer Science Award. Carson Kerr and Logan Bolin tested the effect of different soil types on ZMA's growth. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating. Katie Daniels compared showers and baths to determine which was more efficient. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, she received a first place rating. Haley Heaton and Alyssa Wiltermood compared different types of road de-icers and measured the effect on planary regeneration. Unfortunately, they did not get the opportunity to present their work. Jaden Turpin and Zeke Putnam compared filters with different carbon particle sizes to determine which was more efficient. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating and first overall in physical science. At the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating in the Mosley Consumer Science Award. Jaron Henry and Griffin Tippy tested to see if different types of medicine could be mistaken for candy. At both the Culver-Stockton Science Fair and the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating. Liliana Weiss and Gracie Arthur compared different types of biomasses and measured biogas production. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating and first overall in chemistry. At the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating. Savannah Ramsey and Amanda Stevens built microbial fuel cells and measured the effect of biostimulation on energy production. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating and first overall in math and engineering. At the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating and many special awards, including the Broadchem Masters Top Junior High Project. Brody Rampley and Andre Roberts tested different types of cell phone distractions on reaction time. At both the Culver-Stockton Science Fair and the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating. Katie O'Neill measured the effect of biostimulation on plant growth. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, she received a first place rating and third overall in botany. Aspen Bostic and Tiana Smith tested the effect of color on taste. At both the Culver-Stockton Science Fair and the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating. Brylan Lance and Abigail Schaefer measured the effect of fertilizer runoff on algae buildup. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating and third overall in environmental science. At the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating. Carter Hitz and Mason Fry measured the effect of temperature on bull semen quality. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating and first overall in zoology. At the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating. Jarrett Van Beck and Owen Rigg measured the effect of Roundup on planaria regeneration. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating and first overall in environmental science. At the Regional Science Fair, they received a first place rating, the Mosley Consumer Science Award, and the Broadcom Masters Top Junior High Project. Kendra Lilly and Zoe Griswold measured the effect of solar disinfection on water quality. At the Culver-Stockton Science Fair, they received a first place rating, and at the Regional Science Fair, they received the first place rating and the Broadcom Masters Top Junior High Project. I would like to congratulate the Southeastern Junior High Science Club for receiving the award for the Outstanding Junior High Chapter. Unfortunately, our year was cut short and they weren't able to compete at all the science.
We are back for the final installment of the Big Three. This time we're going to give away a fourth $250 award for one of the students who excelled in all three categories, attendance and discipline, and the other one that I hadn't thought of yet, like academics. So let's look at the seventh graders who were are eligible for this by excelling in all three categories. Gracie Arthur, Logan Bolin, Jaron Henry, Carson Kerr, Owen Northern, Savannah Ramsey, Amanda Stevens, Jaden Turpin, Mitchell Wilcox, Hannah Ensminger, Mason Fry, Zoe Griswold, Carter Hitz, Liam Enan, James Landon, Brylan Lance, Kendra Lilly, Katie O'Neill, Owen Rigg, Abigail Schaefer, and Jarrett Van Beck. Congratulations to those students. Great, great job. Continue excelling at the big three. When you get into high school, you're going to find Southeastern a great place. Let's get going. $250. I need Mr. Rigg again. We're going to pretend like he's over there, and we're going to ask him a question. Mr. Rigg, do you ever have a favorite toy as a child or anything like that? We talked about your pets. What about any toys that you really liked?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Definitely. Yeah. Jack in the Box.
Okay. Yeah. I just happen to have a Jack in the Box that we could kind of mess with a little bit. It happens to be right here. And what we can do with it is, you'd be familiar with this. I'm sure this isn't going to be too exciting or too surprising for you. But we can go keep seventh, rid seventh, keep eighth, or rid eighth again. We have it set. And so let's do the, just because I think I'm going to like how this works, and you guys trust me now on how this works. We're just going to go with the first one. Whoever, whatever the first one says, that's what we're going to do. And with every good Jack in the Box, we need good Jack in the Box music. Mr. Rigg, do you remember the song, the Jack in the Box song? Would you mind doing this?
I can do it.
Okay. We're going to get rid of, thank you. We're going to get rid of the eighth graders. We're going to get rid of the eighth graders. Okay, so that means these fellas and ladies down here are no longer with us. Let's do some house cleaning real quick. Have any of these other students already won $250? Savannah. Wouldn't be fair to win twice. That's one of our rules. So sorry, Savannah. You don't win $500. Just you have to be happy with $250. Anybody else have won already? Okay. So since we really, really liked the Jack in the Box song before, let's go ahead and continue and do this again. Keep girls. Keep boys, rid girls, and rid boys. For those of you who watched the high school awards ceremony, you know which one Mr. Gooding would be going for right now, but we'll go further. Keep girls, keep boys, rid of girls, rid of boys. Set it. Mr. Rigg, please do the honors. We're gonna get rid of the boys here, okay. I'm gonna get rid of the boys, so Logan and Jaron and Carson and Owen and this is gonna be exciting. And Jaden and Mitchell, you are all gone, leaving us. Sorry, Owen. Gracie Arthur and Amanda Stevens, you're our only two left. Let's go see what we can find. Let's go with any requests out there. How about, since this is a pot of gold we're talking about, $250, let me go to the pot of gold. Let me show you how the pot of gold works. First of all, there it is, pot of gold, it's two. Who's it to? We click the button and we see this to Jacob. Unfortunately, let's see. We do not have any Jacobs, so we're going to have to personalize this. Gracie. We have, hang with me here. We have four people involved here. We have, of course, we have Gracie. We have Amanda. We also have Arthur. And we also have Steven. How about that? You see what I did there? Gracie, we have Amanda, we have Arthur, and we have Stevens. We have our set. We're going to go with, Mr. Rigg, favorite number between 1 and 5?
2.
2. We're going to go with the second winner. So the first winner is not Gracie. So Gracie, you didn't win, unless you did. Our winner is going to be the next person. Which is going to be, reset it, our next person, our winner of 250, the last 250 of the year of awards day for big three, excelling in attendance and in discipline and in academics. The winner of 250 is, are you ready? The winner is Arthur, which I think that's Gracie. So Gracie, congratulations. You are the winner of 250. Good job.
Inside my head, hands up if you're down to get down tonight. 'Cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere. I'm in if you're down to get down tonight. 'Cause it's always a good time.
Good morning and good night.
You're gonna wish these
days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good